Hi, beautiful friends. My name is Ezekiel. Hope you are doing wonderfully. In today's video, I will be walking you through arrangers and markers in Cakewalk Sonar. You might not have known, Sonar have been highly developed and it has been embedded with a lot of new features and more quality audio and more stability. But these tools that I'm going to be showing you are not that new, but it added with more features and details upon. And if you're not a Cakewalk user, please don't leave this video. This doesn't really matter if you're not a Cakewalk user, because it's available in all professional DAW, if not all. Now, using arranger and markers in projects like this, whenever you are doing music production, you are doing editing and mixing, this is a fantastic tool for you to get started with that is going to help your workflow to be smooth, faster, and more enjoyable. Arranger is a beautiful tool in DAW nowadays that will help you. But before we move on, if you're new to this channel, please, I want to plead you to subscribe to this channel so that whenever I upload new videos, so you'll be able to receive the notification as soon as this one is done. So I'm going to be walking you through this one, so you're going to see how it works in this project. So now let's go into that. I'm going to be showing you how this one looks like in this. All right, so here is the project. Now I'm gonna be playing this project, maybe to skip from one place to another, but just needed to listen to how the music sounds like so that you'll be able to understand when I begin to do the demonstration in this one. Now listen to the intro first, going to the lead vocal part, to the chorus and some part, so we'll move on with that. Alright, you just listen to the intro, and now if you look at this place, let me show you something here. Up here, here is where the lead vocal comes in, then it goes to the chorus, and look up here where the markers are, and from the lines where the moving tools are, look at the verse, look at the marker here, I've not labeled this one, and move down there, this is where verse 2 is, and this is chorus 3, and the bridge down to the pre-chorus, which is gonna Now let's go back to this one. The first thing that I'm going to be doing here, I'm going to be marking from the lead part to some sections that I can easily move to get it to, and you understand how the marker works now. So I'm going to be putting a playback here so that I can be able to mark on my DAW. I use shortcut, so you're going to be on Windows, I'm going to be clicking M. So it's bringing out the marker dialog box, then which I'm going to be labeling this part as lead vox. So take a look at that part. So lead vox is marked on that part. So this is the first thing that I'm going to be doing. And next thing, I have the chorus. So the next thing I have, verse 2 down to, okay, let me play here so that I can understand what is here. I don't want to open the lead vocal yet, just the lead down vocal that is still in this project, but I don't want to, it's an ongoing project. I don't want to open that vox for now. So let's listen to this part. Okay, so we have verse and this part is chorus. I already inserted the marker. So what I did is that just right click on that, because I already have the marker here. So if you right click on the marker, it's going to bring the dialog box for you to relabel or to name. So that's chorus one. So which I have here. Chorus one. Okay. Then the verse 2 is going there, and chorus 3. Bridge. Now from the bridge we have pre-chorus on this part, so I'm going to be labeling this part the pre-chorus. Now M pre-chorus. So from there it goes down to the outro. Okay, outro. All right, so the labeling of the market is done on the project. So, and one thing, if you are not using the shortcut, so the easy way to do that, then you right click on it and go to insert. It's going to bring you the dialog box. So to have your functions and to go way to that. So that's all about that. Now we have the outro and that one is done. That is has been done. Now, the next thing which I want to show you is that I want to add, this is a new feature in Sonar. So the start and end marker, which is going to help my production workflow to be so easy. By the time I play the song from the beginning, it's going to play from where the start marker is from and it's going to end where the marker ends on. So this is what you do. So what you are going to do is you highlight first. When you highlight first, then you are going to right click. It's going to bring the information for you to select the command or the function or the tool that you want to use. So I'm going to be clicking on set project start and end markers to selection. So now I done that. So look at the end of the song here. You look at the red marker here. So look at where it's back from me. So when it was highlighted, look at the end. This is the red flag end. And let's go back to the beginning. So, all right. So if you want to go by that, you are going to highlight everything. So when you highlight it, it's going to highlight from the beginning of the song down to where the song ends, where it's automatically seeing the end of the project. Look at one thing I'm going to be doing here is that I'm going to be dragging the mark, that's this white marker that has white and green marker here. I'm going to be dragging that for the beat so that this, if I apply the marker, that's where it's going to start from. Because if I allow it to start from count one, that's where it's going to, it's not going to insert the marker properly. So I'm going to be doing that and pull it forward a bit. Now going to the front. So the front and back is marked. Then after done with that, so however, from there, you right click from there, set project start and end markers to selection. Look at the first beginning here. Look at the start and then let's go to the end. Okay. You already see the end. So that's how my start to end marker is done. Now, if I set to play, look at something here. When I click on W button on my keyboard, it's set back to the where the start from, where the start is. Something that is funny here, that is so interesting, that I love here is, even if I press the click on the W again to set back to count one, if I'm going to play this song, it's going to start from where the start is. So let's take a look at that now. Now, look at that again. Now the music is starting from where the start mark is, so which is interesting. You don't need to even go by then. Then something interesting, and if the song is going and it's going to stop by itself, except if you loop the song. Now take a look at that. Let's see, play from the outro a bit towards the end of the outro. Now, this is so interesting. Maybe you are just playing for your artist to listen from the beginning to the end. Maybe you just stepped out or you're doing something. So this song will just stop by this. Though Sonar has the feature which is automatically start playing, it's going to stop at the end of the project. But this is so smart, more smarter than that function. So that's about that. So, and another thing which I'm going to be showing you on this part, on the marker part before I go into the arranger is that, so let's take a look at it. Marker. Now you can skip back to the next tool, back to next tool, back to the next one, which is more easier and so fine. And then you can skip forward again. Then if you want to mark, let's assume that you have not, you want to do a new mark on that. So maybe you're just listening to the song to that part of it. And you stop on that part. So when you're already on marker, you can add marker on it by clicking on that part. So the marker is being inserted just for you to label love. And so that's about that part. All right, let's quickly go into arranger now and see how it works. So the first thing that you're going to be doing on the arranger is you click on the left corner of Sonar and you will see the A symbol here. You click on it, it's going to open so that you'll be able to see whatever you are doing. After that, going from the beginning, I'm going to go, let's set this one to all. Then from the start, I'm going to be left click dragging on this part to see where it starts from. So that start is my intro. After being done with that, okay, then another one. I'm going to be doing everything like that.
I'm going to be doing everything like that. Okay, it's a chorus. That's verse. Chorus one. Okay, verse two. The bridge. The chorus.
All right, so there's something that I forgot to do, which I explained earlier on, is to add markers to where the pre-chorus entered. So you already know how that one is being done. Okay. All right, the pre-chorus. So the only thing that left here is the outro. Now the arranger is done, but not fully done. I already placed the arranger, which will enable me to walk through the project. Then what I'm going to be doing now is from the first section, then you click on there. It's going to bring out the dialog box for you to select color, rename. The first thing that I'm going to be doing now, I'm going to be renaming first. Intro. Now, lead vox. So what next? So you can see the way I'm labeling that, and it's already showing here. I'm going to be copying from here so that it can be more faster for me, easier for me. Verse 1, then chorus 2, and chorus 2. Okay, so what next? Then outro. All right, my arranger is done. Everything is done. So one thing I'm going to be showing you, the advantage of arranger, like I've shown to you in the review of Sonar, the short review that I did on Sonar. Then one thing I show you, let's assume I want to rearrange the project. So what is going to be more benefit for me is that, for example, let's say I want to double the chorus. Now, what I'm going to be doing is that, let's take a look at this part. Just click on the chorus arranger part and you drag back to the beginning of the verse, and it's going to automatically drop that, and there's a space here. So just click on control and drag back. It's going to copy that part to this place. So that one is done. There are other ways to go by that, is that you create the space first, but this is so smart and easier. So that's about that. Let me undo that. So the chorus is going to come after the bridge before it gets to the pre-chorus. So now I'm going to bring the chorus to in between the bridge and pre-chorus. So let's say we want to do it that way. You just click on control, drag one of the chorus, and you bring it down here. You can see how it copied from that chorus is just dropped, and it creates a space for itself on that part. This about the arranger. This wow, and this how much easier and so smooth. I love the way it's flowing. And for me, instead of to find the other way, that is long process for me. Now let's say, okay, I want to listen to that part alone. So one thing you're gonna see, go to arranger track. Now before then, I already have the chorus labeled. You can see all the chorus. I want to give same color to all the chorus. Now the chorus one, chorus two, the chorus three, all the chorus, they have different color. So I want to give them the color. So let me use the first color for every other one. Then I'm going to be going to the section color. So that one's already there. So chorus two, I want to give same color to chorus two. Now it's done. No, done. Same color to chorus two. That one is done. Chorus three, that one is going to be done. So this one, which I said, okay, I want to do like that. So let's say I'm going to rename that one. So which this one is going to be chorus four. Let's assume that's four. Okay, chorus 4, then pre-chorus. I can leave the pre-chorus like that. Then my intro and outro, I want to give them the same color, or if you choose to leave it that same way. So you can see that outro colored and it can go with the green. One thing is that I'm going to be pretending as if I'm playing the song and I want to listen to other parts of the song, which is far, far close to pre-chorus. Now I'm playing from verse 1. I want to jump to pre-chorus or chorus 4. So let's see how it's going to happen like that. Now you can see that is very easy for me to do. You can just like shortcut, just click on the button. So it's moved from verse 1, I jump to a chorus 4, or pre-chorus, you can jump to anywhere by clicking on. But lastly, on the arranger, if you only want to play on the pre-chorus, just want to hear what's on that, you want to listen to that again, you can see that it has a play symbol. So let's see how it's going to be. You saw what just happened. So it's just like we are previewing without stretching yourself. Just click on that button. Just put your cursor on it and it's going to play for you. And when it gets to the end of that part or that section, it's going to stop by itself. Now with the marker, let's say you are playing and you are playing the song. You want to move from one part to another part. So let's see how that also works on the marker. You can see what is happening here by clicking on the marker button to go forward, just like you are playing on the tape and you're just clicking on the skip forward. The same thing happening on the marker here. And look at, if I want to skip backward, I just double click on the marker, it just moves. So that's all about this one today. I hope you enjoyed what you've just watched, and I hope you have learned something from this video. So probably you have any question or you have anything to say about what you've just watched. Which one do you think it's more easier for you to flow with, between the arranger and the marker? Which one is better for you? Put down the comment below, let's say, and what you learned from it. So if you truly enjoyed this video, please don't hesitate to thumb up for me for YouTube and glory to me. And if you're new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe and click on all notification button so you get to know whenever I upload new videos like this. Thank you so much for stopping by to watch this video. See you in the next time. Bye.